Good morning children, let's begin today's lesson. Today we will discuss about position of adverbs. In my previous video I have explained you about adverbs, that adverbs tells you more about the verb, adjective or another adverb in a sentence. Now it's position in a sentence. Students, adverbs take different position in a sentence, normally as adverb of manner. It is used before adjectives or other adverbs in a sentence. So let's discuss adverb of manner. It's reasonably cheap restaurant and food served here is extremely good. Both reasonably and extremely are adverbs used before adjectives. What are your adjectives? Cheap and good. I am terribly sorry. I didn't mean to push you. Here, adverb is your terribly. मतलब किस हद तक? Manner means किस तरह से कोई भी घटना घटा आपका. देखिए यहाँ पे terribly बुरे तरीके से. I am terribly means दिल से. यहाँ पे sorry कहने के sense में I am terribly sorry. Use before adjective sorry. Okay. Third is your children learn languages incredibly quickly. Incredibility means आपका यहाँ पे अतुलनीय ढंग से. Adverb incredibly used before another adverb quickly. Note, not all words ending in ly are adverbs. Some adjectives end in ly too. Example, friendly, lively, elderly, lonely, silly, lovely, etc. So in an adverb, and therefore it is used before an adjective or adverb in a sentence, while such is an adjective and it is used before another adjective or noun in a sentence. Both so and such make the meaning of an adjective or adverb clearer in a sentence. Let's look at the examples. The book was so good that I could not stop myself from buying it. Here adverb so used before adjective good. Okay. Sometimes it is difficult to understand him as he speaks so quickly. Here adverb is your so used before another adverb quickly. I have not seen her for so long that I have forgotten how she looks like. Here adverb so used before adjective long. So student, this I have explained you earlier also, that so is your adverb and therefore it is used before an adjective or adverb in a sentence, while such is an adjective. Clear? Next is your adverb of time. It can be used either after the main verb and object of the sentence or before, at the beginning of the sentence, the subject, but in that case it should be followed by a comma. Okay. Examples, look at the example students. She called me up yesterday. Here yesterday, which is adverb of time, comes after the main verb called and object me. Okay. Yesterday she called me up. Here yesterday, the adverb of time comes at the beginning of the sentence followed by a comma. This already I have explained. In case a sentence has more than one adverb or all the three adverbs, adverb of manner, adverb of place and adverb of time. Here we are talking about all the three adverbs in the same sentence. So what will happen? They take the position as given in the following sentence structure. अगर तीनों एक साथ हैं तो कौन सा पहले होगा, कौन सा बाद में होगा? We will do according to this sentence structure. Subject plus main verb plus adverb of manner पहले आएगा आपका, फिर आएगा adverb of place, then your adverb of time. Example, they worked hard in the field the whole day. Here hard is the adverb of manner, field is the adverb of place and hold is the adverb of time. Okay students, next is your adverb of degree. It is used before adjective or adverb but after main verb in a sentence. Okay. Examples, The questions are very difficult. Adverb of degree very comes before the adjective difficult, but after the verb are. Okay, I did the homework almost asleep by the end of the day. Adverb of degree almost comes before the adverb asleep, but after the verb did. Okay, next is your adverb of frequency. It is used before the main verb in a sentence. Okay, he usually comes to my house in the evening. Sometimes it rains hard in the month of July. They often disturb me in my work. He rarely comes in our colony. Students, here usually, sometimes, often, rarely are your examples of adverb of frequency. Okay. Next is your adverbs like already, just, and still come in between the main verb and auxiliary verb. Let's look at the examples. The bus had already arrived. Okay. The teacher has just come in the classroom. I am still waiting for his reply. So these are the adverbs which comes in between the main verb and the auxiliary verb. Next is your but adverb. Yet comes at the end of a sentence after the main verbs and object. This can come after the main verb. Okay. He has not replied to my letters yet. The rain has not stopped yet. So these are the examples of adverb that comes after the verb or at the end in a sentence. Students, here you can see exercises. One, you will have to do, already the answers are tick marks are there in the correct answer. Here, students, you can see exercise number 2. Both the words you will have to write in the single blank. Suppose look at the example number 1. The examination question paper was, you can see I have marked in both the boxes, in this one and this one, both. Here arranged one is there and painstakingly. Okay, so the examination question paper was arranged painstakingly. Secondly, some passengers of the train were, here you can see I have marked 2A and B, so injured and badly. Okay, my best friend's mother is, you can see ill, and here seriously. Okay, so you can do it in the same way. Next is your number 3. This also you will have to do in your classwork copy. Next is your number 4, students. This much only you will have to write as the heading of the question. Rewrite the following sentences. Okay, and your brain ticklers as an activity. I hope this will be clear to all of you. Students, go through the lessons, complete your work. If you have any queries, you can ask me with the help of your class teacher. Thank you.